Today we're going to be showing you how to create a teleportation effect inspired by the Umbrella Academy. If you're interested in trying out the effect for yourself, you can find the footage down in the description. Let's go ahead and dive right in and get started. Here we've got the four shots that we're going to stitch together. The first one is Tom running and jumping into the air. The second is him throwing the shoe, then picking up the shoe, and finally a clean plate with nothing happening. It's important when you're trying to make a visual effect that has something disappear that you get a clean plate. This is because otherwise you have to paint out the object, which can be difficult or even impossible depending on what kind of environment you're in. So let's go ahead and get started by creating a new composite shot, and I'll just call this main comp and make it about 8 or 9 seconds long. And we're gonna put all of the footage into this comp. So I'll start with the running and jumping, which is very short. And then after that, we're gonna wanna cut to the shoe throwing, which is here. After the shoe settles down, we're gonna wanna cut to the clip of him picking it up. And we'll just put the clean plate under that for now. The first thing I want to do is make Tom disappear. And after that, we can start layering up effects to make it a bit more interesting. But the first thing you need to get out of the way is the actual disappearance. So right now it's a jump cut and it has Tom still in the second clip here. I'm going to use Fractal Noise to create the transition of Tom disappearing, just so that I don't have to do it manually and it's more random. So let's create a new comp, and I'll call this Fractal, and make it just about 1 second long. It's a very quick transition. Inside of this, I'll create a new plane and add the Fractal Noise effect onto it. In the controls panel, let's change the type to smoke, but you can use whatever works best for your footage. And in the appearance section, I'll come in and keyframe the exposure and the offset, and I'll turn the exposure all the way up. You'll see this later, but what this means is the screen is entirely white, which means that all of Tom will be visible. And then over the course of maybe 10 frames, so you can skip forward or use the shortcut, we're gonna bring the exposure back down as well as the offset. So what this results in is the screen going from white to black, but with a more interesting transition than just a straight fade. And you can tweak the properties of the fractal noise. So you can have it more like blobs, or you can have it more bitty and more grainy. That'll be up to you. Let's see how it looks in the actual comp first. So I'll go back into the main comp and bring the fractal down into it and hide it from view. And then I'll position the start point at the same spot that I want the transition to actually start. Onto this first footage of Tom jumping, I'll add the set matte effect. And in the controls panel, set the source layer to the fractal. So it's going to use whatever is in the fractal noise comp to generate the transition between the two clips. And then I'll set the matte source from alpha to luminance. So this means it's going to use the black and white values, which is important because that's what our fractal noise is based on. And if I play it back, you can see Tom fading in that fractal noise pattern. And this is where you can go back and adjust the fractal noise to get it looking the way that you want. If I come in and increase the scale, the pieces will be bigger. And that's up to you, depending on whatever look you're going for. If you want more movement, what you can also do is keyframe the seed property. So I'll just skip forward a little bit and change it to 20. And this means the fractal noise will be changing as it transforms, which just gives it a bit more variety. So obviously we've transitioned into a clip where Tom is still standing there and we can't have that. So let's grab this clean plate. I'm gonna rename these real quick. One thing I forgot to mention is that the Tom jump layer, if you go back past where the fractal noise begins, the clip will go black because the fractal doesn't exist at that point, and so it thinks, oh, you don't want any of it to show. So to prevent that, all you have to do is choose the slice tool and make a cut where the transition should start, then remove the set matte effect from that first piece of footage. So this piece is completely normal, and then this one has the set matte effect on it, which is down here. So let's take Tom out of this clip here. We've got the shoe throw, but we don't want him to be visible. So what I'll do is select the shoe throw clip and come up to the freehand mask tool, and I'll just go ahead and draw a shape around the shoe. There isn't anything behind it at the moment, so it'll appear black. I can move the clean plate forward in time there so that it fills in that space. If at any point you want the transition to happen earlier or later, you can do that just by moving the clip itself. So let's say we want it to start right there. I could just trim that bit off and fill that in, and then scoot the fractal noise and the clean plate backwards. This makes Tom and the shoe line up a bit better. They're not perfect, but that's something to keep in mind on set. You're gonna wanna get the object or whatever it is kind of exactly in the same spot as your actor. So be sure to review the footage to get that right. What we have now is Tom jumping through the air, having a transition, and the shoe flying off by itself as we want. To get the shoe pickup, what I'll do is just mask out that area similar to the way I did the actual shoe throw. And then because we have the clean plate under it, it will look very similar to the shot before it. And you can feather that mask in the controls panel to make it a bit of a smoother transition. Now we've got the transition down, we can start adding some effects to enhance the teleportation effect. The first one we're going to add is the bulge effect. So to do that, I'll add a new layer and then a new grade and drop the bulge effect onto that grade. You can use either the sliders in the controls panel or the viewer control here to position and resize it. So this inner circle here is how much of the screen it affects, and then the dashed line is how much or how little the bulge actually is. So let's have it start at zero, and then I'll keyframe that bulge to, over a couple of frames, go inwards. So it's kind of like Tom is getting sucked into another dimension. I'll skip forward a bit more and bring it out to maybe 0.1. Skip forward a bit more and set it to zero. This gives it a little bit of a bounce instead of just going from zero to -5 to zero again. If you want to keyframe the center to follow Tom, you can do that. I'll go ahead and do it just a little bit because I don't want it to be following him completely. It should be a single point that he's vanishing into, but maybe just a little bit. The next thing I'm going to add is a quick color grade so that you can see a closer result to what it'll look like in the final product. The next effect I'm going to add is light rays, but you can also use the glow effect if you don't have the add-on pack. I'll put this on a new grade because I found that it extended really far. It basically covered the entire screen. And if you don't want that, you want to be able to mask the grade so that it's only affecting a certain portion of the screen. So I'll go ahead and keyframe the intensity similar to the fractal noise. We'll go from zero up to maybe 0.6 and then back down again to zero. And you can use the period key to skip forward one frame at a time and the comma key to go back. But I have those customized to W and E because I find it easier to use. I'll also keyframe the position because this should move with Tom, I think. So I'll skip forward and just move it along. And it's a very quick effect. You shouldn't really be able to pick apart the details. It goes by in a flash, so the position and stuff don't really need to be exact. Another effect that might be useful is heat distortion, so I'll go ahead and put that on its own grade because I know I definitely don't want that to affect the entire clip. Heat distortion is part of HitFilm Express, but we also do have a couple of other add-on options for different results. The process is basically the same for all these effects. You're really just turning them on and off over a couple of frames. So I won't spend too long on this. But like I said, I don't want it affecting the entire frame, and it is right now. So what I'll do is just draw an ellipse mask on that layer so that it's only affecting this area. And I'll go ahead and feather it as well.
So that's pretty much it for this effect if you're basing it off of the Umbrella Academy. But teleportation can take a lot of different looks, so definitely give it a try yourself. If you make something really cool, you can share it with us at showoff@fxhome.com. Leave any questions you guys might have down below. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you all in the next video.